6:15. At last report, the Blue Springs High School band was almost home after that whirlwind trip to Washington, D.C.
Of course, the band marched in the inaugural parade on Tuesday. KMBC 9's Jana Corey live at Blue Springs High School this morning. And, you know, my guess is they haven't slept much since. And I know they didn't sleep much before that, from what you say, Jana.
No, it certainly was a whirlwind trip. You know, we just got word that they're supposed to be here any minute, and all the parents have lined up with signs. I want to bring in one of the parents. This is Elizabeth Spangler. Come
Hi.
On over. Show us your sign, first of all.
Well, before they left, it was DC bound, and now that they're coming home, it's we love you. Glad to have you home.
Now, you have a daughter in the band, and tell us what she's been telling you. Here they come, actually. Let's look at them in the distance.
So cool. They have had a wonderful time. They're tired, but glad to be home. It was an experience of a lifetime. They're part of history, and they wouldn't have traded it for anything, despite the crowds and all the security. It was such an experience and such an opportunity for them to be able to go. We are all just so thankful and grateful and so glad that they're here.
And here we see they have a police escort bringing them in. They had that police escort on the way out as well. Five charter buses here bringing them in. Lots of proud parents here waving. There are 220 students here that have taken part in this trip, and they are quite exhausted. I know that they had little chance to get much sleep. I know that the bus rides were exhausting. What was the sleep situation? What did your daughter tell you? Did she get any?
They did this last evening. I could tell by her voice that she had gotten quite a bit of sleep. They hadn't slept much prior to this because they had to be online for the parade at such an early hour. And it took a lot out of them, but, you know, they're kids and they're resilient, and it was worth the wait. It was worth the wait and the lack of sleep. And they're pre-abbed from school today, so they'll get a good nap. So that's great.
And I see you have a little tear in your eye. Has this been emotional for her to be part of this?
Absolutely. What a moment in history. I mean, just to be able to watch it on TV, was very emotional. I can only imagine being there. That the kids said that it was just something that they will never forget. One of the girls said she turned, she wasn't supposed to look out. They told them not to look, but she looked out of the corner of her eye and she just said, "This is so amazing," and started to cry as she was marching. So that's just how phenomenal it was. Even though, you know, they weren't there for the speech itself, to be there at the parade, to march by this historic president at this historic point in time, to be there on the DC Mall and everything was really cool.
And you said your daughter wants to be a social studies teacher, so this had a special significance for her.
Absolutely. This is something that she'll tell her classes for years to come. At first, it was a little hard to soak in the enormity of it, but once they got there, it was really, really there. And they all said, you know, we are so proud to be part of this history. So.
And I want to give you a look here because we're seeing the buses. We're seeing all of the proud parents lining up here, ready to welcome their sons and their daughters home from this very proud moment. They left late Saturday night. The bus ride, let me tell you, 19 hours. So you might be seeing a lot of very tired students rolling off of these buses this morning. But as we mentioned earlier, they have a free pass to stay out of school today. So that is the good news. I'm going to talk to some parents if we can here. I see you looking. Do you see them? Do you see them?
They're looking so hard. We're looking at the bus numbers to figure out which our child's bus were, because ours are on the same bus.
Bus 3. Yep. Where's bus 3?
Have you talked to them this morning? What have they told you about the trip?
They're exhausted.
Really exhausted.
Glad to be home. They had a great time.
What did they say about the moment, about being part of history?
I know that my daughter was extremely excited. However, I can't feel my feet. I can't feel my fingers.
Yeah.
She was ready for it to be over, but she was so thrilled to be part of the history.
Yes.
And did they talk about the security at all? Because I know that they had to sit on the buses for hours because they had to get to that secured location before all of the streets were closed down. What did they say about the security and the waiting?
Originally, they were supposed to leave at 2 in the morning to go to the Pentagon, and they ended up having to go at 10 at night and spend the entire night in the parking lot on the bus. I'm sure they're very sick of these buses. They had been told that they would see machine guns and everything along the way, and she didn't really say much about that, so I don't know.
My daughter didn't either, so.
Did they say what is going to stay with them, what they will remember most about it?
Wow. Just the excitement, yeah. The amount of people, again, being part of history, that's something that they will take with them the rest of their lives.
I'm going to see if we can catch up with some of the students here. I'm going to walk down as they're getting off the bus. You can see them with pillows and screams as they are very tired but yet excited to be home. Let's see if we can catch some of the hugs here. I know you just woke up, probably just got back. How was the trip? What was it like?
So fun. It was awesome. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and it was so awesome. It was amazing.
What are you going to remember most? What moment?
I don't know. All of it was just so awesome. Probably just, like, marching down and just seeing, like, Obama in there, and it was just so cool seeing him watching us and so happy. It was awesome.
Did you get any sleep? What was the sleep situation like?
It was pretty good. Everybody either was on the floor or in a seat, and it was pretty good. I had a seat to myself, so I got some sleep.
Well, thanks for sharing. We're going to keep walking here. I know we've seen so many hugs. It's been a lot of fun to get to see everyone reunited. I'm going to walk down here a little bit further as we're seeing some nice hugs. Hi there. How are you? We're with Channel 9. How was your trip? What are you going to remember most?
My trip was exciting. I mean, it was just such an opportunity, and I don't know, I don't think I've experienced anything like it again. And the best thing was probably just seeing President Obama and just being there and being there at that moment and feeling everything. And
now, you have on PJs, bathrobe. Yeah. Did you get some sleep on the bus? I hear it was 19 hours.
Yeah, it was about 19 hours. We slept around 4 to 5 hours. On the bus, I mean, it's really difficult to sleep on a bus, and it's just, it was amazing.
What was it like to actually walk in the parade? Did you get a chance to see Barack Obama? Did you look over? I know you were supposed to look straight ahead. What was that experience like? I know it was supposed to be cold. Tell us about the actual feeling.
It actually heated up whenever we got into the actual city, and whenever we were passing with Barack Obama, you could see him through, like, your peripheral vision and to, like, the left. And my mom said that Mrs. Obama was dancing to our song, and I think that's just really cool that she liked it so much. But we all saw Obama and Joe Biden and everyone, and it was just awesome.
Do you think this is something that you'll tell children, grandchildren, for years to come?
I'm pretty sure I will, because this is history. And I think that's just so exciting.
Very fun to see all of this in action, to get to see all of the kids coming off the bus. They're taking their instruments. They are taking their pillows, backpacks, sleeping bags. It has certainly been a long night and a long trip on this 19-hour bus ride back home from a moment that they certainly will never forget, being part of Barack Obama's inaugural parade. We will have much more from the Blue Springs Band, from Blue Springs High School. I'm Jana Corey. Back to you in the studio.
Very good. All right. Thank you, Jana, and to our crew out there. And speaking of the band, we received a wonderful email that we would like to share with you this morning from Petty Officer Rafael Beltran III.
Now, he escorted the band around Washington, D.C., and part of the email reads, "I want everyone to know that your sons and daughters made you proud, and they reflect this great nation of ours I am willing to fight for. I could not have been given a better high school band to escort. Thank you for the privilege and the honor." We're going to leave it at that, and we'll see you after this.